Spain was kind of divided into very rich people who tended to be on the side of the Roman Catholic Church. And then on the other side, there were the workers and the more liberal people. And the rich people and the church were unhappy with the newly elected government, which was called the Republican government, because they were inclined to take away a lot of the power of the rich, and they were also taking away a lot of the power of the Roman Catholic Church.
Teaches you to be alone, the present to be afraid of cold. So if I count you rabbits, then I count you fascists.
That was Jack Nalty's house that we stopped outside, and this is where the plaque will be, which is roughly around where his father came to work in the oil company. When we're finished here, we're going to go around to the community centre, as I said. We're going to show a short film and we're going to launch the pamphlet. The pamphlet, it's very important to say, wouldn't have happened without the support of the Nugent family, who are the relatives of Jack Nalty. In the late 90s, Steve Nugent started researching the life and death of his uncle Jack. And he self-published a book at that time called No Coward Soul. And it was his research that was used for the basis of what we're publishing today. And sadly, Steve died in December last year. We had talked about this event, but sadly he's not here to see it. But we do have a message from Steve's daughter on behalf of that branch of the family, which will be read out now.
Steve has five daughters, and they were sorry that none of them could come here today. They remember when he wrote the book, he was just finished work, he'd retired, and he decided to research Jack Nalty. He always had a fascination about Jack, and it was a real labour of love. It took him 6 years to get the book written, got a lot of information from people, and he travelled a lot. He put ads in the Irish Independent, put an ad in the Irish Times to try and get people to contact him. So his daughters remember well, the book was launched in a pub, funny enough, in Toronto, and a lot of people really enjoyed it, and he really got great feedback from people, and he was delighted that he did it. And coincidentally, Steve died, as Joe said, in December, and today would have been Steve's 88th birthday, if he was alive. So again, it's a sort of a special occasion to have him there.
Keep it short, he said. Friends of the International Brigade is a present form of a broad membership honouring the memory, the reasons, the motivations of the International Brigade. Going back to 1986 in Boswell's Hotel with Ronnie Drew, with Manus's father and with many other brigaders, and the sister of Frank Ryan, who was the inspiration of that event. And the aim of it is to commemorate people, to give us the meaning of their struggle for our days. It is not about something conserved in the past, behind a glass case. It's an example of a motivation and struggle based on one overriding principle, and that principle is solidarity. Solidarity could not be better expressed and somebody who's been wounded and come back from Spain goes out again when any clear-headed person knows that war is almost certainly lost, but went back because their comrades were still there. And being killed in an act of solidarity is as direct a witness as we could ask for. It's not something anybody contemplates clearly, but those things do happen to some people, and they're happening in that way is something that we can use in our daily lives. When we are in a city with a housing crisis, which ministers call a crisis, but treat with joy. when we have the richest party representing the richest people, making the most in house price rises and rent increases, and we're supposed to look to them to solve it. It was crises like Ireland's housing crisis of the 1930s that produced the atmosphere where the people we're commemorating today understood solidarity, understood the need, if necessary, to break the law to save the people, and finally went to a country where the law was being broken to attack the people. And even then, with the law on their side, the establishment could not support them. But we support those who did it then, and we look to support the same people today. Thank you.
Before we unveil the plaque, just I should have also, when we're welcoming people, I should have welcomed the elected members. So my apologies if I leave anybody out. Mary Lou MacDonald, Sean Crow, Gay Fagan, and Ciarán Perry, I think are the elected members here. If I left anyone out, please remind me. Okay, thank you. Now, as Harry just said, Jack died gone, not only was it his second time in the battlefield, they were in retreat, and he risked his life to go back and risked his life to save two men, and that's when he died. We have a message from the granddaughter of one of the men he saved, Sid Boot, who had said recently, she posted some of the stuff we had put up about Jack, that her granddad always talked about Jack. Sid was wounded. I think he was hit 7 times, but survived to live into old age. So just a very, very short message from the granddaughter of the man Jack saved.
This is from Vicky Boop. My thoughts are with you all today. R.I.P. Jack, you saved my grandfather's life.
He arrived in December, just around Christmas time in 1936. And things were at a bad stage of the war because the Republicans were being very pushed and the Nationalists were taking over. The Nationalists were headed by a man called Francisco Franco, who was a very powerful general.
And now, just before we have to unveil, and we will have James Nugent, another relative of Jack Nalty, who will... we'll do the unveil and then we'll say a few words. And just again, things I keep forgetting to say. The book also has a number which you will be able to purchase when we get around to the centre. Also has a number of contributions of people who had whose family had connections with Jack Nalty in those times. There's a piece by Rita Lestrange about her uncle, Dinny Coady, who died at the fairly early stage in the war. There's a contribution from Manus about his father's connection with Jack Nalty. There's a piece by Brian Hanley that sets out the historical context of why these men went to fight. There's a piece on Tommy Woods by Sam McGrath, who's not here. He was the youngest person to die. And there's a piece by Derek Gannon, whose family were from the North Wall area and who were instrumental in setting up the support networks in Ireland for people who went out. And of course, I can see him at the back. The book wouldn't have been done without the patience and talent of Kevin Squires, who laid it out and done the design. We forgot him last time. So without further ado, James Nugent is going to say a few words, and James will be cutting the string to unveil the plaque.
It wasn't until Steve published this book that I got a complete picture of who Jack Nalty was. Around that time, I was doing an art course around the North Wall, and part of that was an essay and a painting of my choice. And by chance, I opted for Guernica by Pablo Picasso. And remember reading several accounts of that day, where the fascists, aided by their German counterparts, attacked the town under the guise of destroying a bridge. In the end, the bridge was about the only thing left standing. And I could see how such outrage could inspire those with a social conscience to gather and react. I think Ireland should be proud that there were men of principles and ideals willing to lend a hand and give their lives to fight for another nation. I leave it to yourselves to read Jack's story. He died 26 years before I was born, but I remember his brother Mick, a ship's carpenter who saw the world in the Merchant Navy, and I vaguely remember his sister Maisie, who was mentioned in the book. they were ordinary, decent people who'd been through extraordinary times. Myself and all my relatives are both proud and humble to have such a hero in our family. And I'd like to thank you all for showing interest here, as I always believe that by looking at history, we can understand the present and maybe change the future. Thank you.
Remember Jack Nalty, Dinny Coady, Tommy Woods and Kick Conway, who all had connections with the Docklands and the North Inner City. Christy will play a lament, and then we'll have time for people to place flowers who have brought them. Okay. But first of all, Tom just said people had asked, and I hadn't thought of doing this, what does it actually say on the plaque? Okay, Jack Nalty, 1902 to 1938, Republican Socialist and Trade Unionist, resident of East Road, volunteered in the International Brigade, Spanish Civil War, died in action at the Battle of the Ebro, 23rd of September 1938. And a quote from Jack's last letter home: "It's marvellous what men can endure in support of an ideal." Also remembering his comrades, Dinny Coady, Tommy Wood, Kid Conway, and all the Irish anti-fascists who lost their lives in defence of Spanish democracy, 1936-1938. Eastwall History Group, 2018. Okay, we're going to observe a minute's silence, which Tom is counting off.
It was announced that the international brigades would be withdrawn from Spain, but the Battle of Ebro was on. Jack went in to fight in that, and the day that he was killed, the announcement had already just been made that the international brigades were being withdrawn.
Arise, ye starvelings, from your slumber. Arise, ye prisoners of want. For reason in revolt now thunders, and at last ends the age of cant. Now away with all your superstitions. Servant masses, arise, arise. We'll change forthwith the old conditions and spurn the dust to win the prize. Then comrades, come rally, and the last fight let us face. The Internationale unites the human race. Then comrades, come rally, and the last fight let us face. The Internationale unites the human race. Sheena fina fall, atofe aule gerin, weaned or slew, or teened or ony cooing, favoured vesser, shantir or sheen sher fasta, ni og for fentir on off and troll. An og de hems a varna buel, le gyaun ar gael chon bos no sel, le gon i shrech fel och ne bilair, sholef canig awr on na vin.
Just as we're gathering, if people have flowers, I understand a number of people have flowers from the families, from Anti-Fascist Action and Friends of the International Brigade, so people want to put them there.
And if you tolerate this, then your children will be next. And if you tolerate this, then your children will be next. Will be next, will be next, will be next.
My grandpa was a Republican fighter in the Spanish Civil War, and he was in the Battle of Ebro, as well as Jack Nalty. And he pushed, then he was took as a prisoner. He was sent into a concentration camp in Zaragoza. Then he was there for a few years, pushed, he escaped. And then he was hiding in the mountains until 44 or so, and then the fascists took him as a prisoner, and he was in prison for many years, but he survived. That's why I'm here. And it's very emotional, this, for me, because he died when I was 15 years old, so he was always telling me stories about the Civil War and the International Brigades. And Dolores Ibarruri, it's the speech I'm going to read now. It's La Pasionaria. And actually, he was at one of her speeches, so it's like, I don't know, very emotional. I'd like to do like introductions about the International Brigade and what that means for us, for Spanish people. The wave of solidarity that flows into Spain with the arrival of the International Brigades as Jack Nalty and Frank Grimes, still beating in our hearts, and we are many who still remember them with pride and dignity. Therefore, the children of the defeated, we owe them so much. We cannot thank them enough to come to our country to fight for our war and to be with us in those years when the fascists won the war. They came with solidarity and fraternity, values always associated with the Republic, which we must not forget in these times where fascism and extreme right are re-emerging in Europe. I will proceed to read the farewell speech to the National Brigades, which many of us know almost by heart, in Spanish, of course, not in English, by Dolores Ibarruri, La Pasionaria. And thanks, William. It is very difficult to say a few words in farewell to the heroes of the International Brigades because of what they are and what they represent. A feeling of sorrow and infinite grief catches our throats. Sorrow for those who are going away, for the soldiers or the highest ideal of human redemption, exiles from their countries, persecuted by the tyrants of all peoples. Grief for those who will stay here forever, mingled with the Spanish soil, in the very depth of our hearts, hallowed by your feeling of eternal gratitude. From all peoples, from all races, you came to us like brothers, like sisters, like sons of immortal Spain. And in the hardest days of the war, when the capital of the Spanish Republic was threatened, it was you, gallant comrades of the International Brigades, who helped save the city with your fighting enthusiasm, with your heroism and your spirit of sacrifice. And Jarama and Guadalajara, Brunete and Belchite, Levante and the Ebro, in immortal verses sing of the courage, the sacrifice, the daring, the discipline of the men and the women of the International Brigades. For the first time in the history of the people's struggles, there was the spectacle, breathtaking in its grandeur, of the formation of International Brigades to help save our country's freedom and independence, the freedom and independence of our Spanish land. Communists, socialists, anarchists, republicans, men and women of different colors, different ideology, antagonistic religions, yet all profoundly loving liberty and justice, they came and offered themselves to us unconditionally. They gave us everything, their youth or their maturity, their science or their experience, their blood and their lives, their hopes and aspirations, and they asked us for nothing. But yes, it must be said, they did want a pause in battle. They aspired to the honor of a giant for us. Banners of Spain, salute these many, many heroes, be lowered to honor so many martyrs. Mothers, women, when the years pass by and the wounds of war are stanched, when the memory of the sad and bloody days dissipates in a present of liberty, of peace, when the rancors have died out and pride in a free country is felt equally by all Spaniards, speak to your children. Tell them of these men and women of the International Brigades. Recount from them how, coming over seas and mountains, crossing frontiers bristling with bayonets, shot by ravening dogs thirsting to tear their flesh, these men and women reached our country as crusaders for freedom, to fight and die for Spain's liberty and independence treated by German and Italian fascists. They gave up everything, their loves, their countries, home and fortune, fathers, mothers, wives, brothers, sisters and children. And they came and said to us, we are here, your cause, Spain's cause, is ours. It is the cause of all advanced and progressive mankind. Today, many are departing. Thousands remain shrouded in Spanish earth, profoundly remembered by all Spaniards. Comrades of the International Brigades, political reasons, reasons of state, the welfare of that very cause for which you offered your blood with boundless generosity, are sending you back, some to your own countries and others to forced exile. You can go proudly. You are history. You are legend. You are the heroic example of democracy, solidarity, and universality in the face of the vile and accommodating spirit of those who interpret democratic principles with their eyes on hoards of wealth or corporate shares with the want to safeguard from all risk. We shall not forget you, and when the olive tree of peace is in flower, enter with the victory laurels of the Republic of Spain. Return. Return to our side, for here you will find a homeland. Those who have no country or friends, who must live deprived of friendship, all will have the affection and gratitude of the Spanish people, who today and tomorrow will shout with enthusiasm, long live the heroes of the International Brigades.
That basically ends today's event, is refreshments
here and song.
And a song coming around as well. I would point out, in terms of the film on Harama, the Peter in that film is Peter O'Connor. Peter O'Connor was the man who, along with a couple of Irish brigaders, took Charlie Donnelly's body back on the battlefield. And just recently, the narrative had been that Charlie Donnelly was one of the among 150 Lincoln brigaders who had been killed on the 27th, and their bodies had been burnt because it wasn't possible to dig graves for them. We now know that Charlie Donnelly was 10 days later that his body was recovered from the battlefield. And after a long research, we now know where Charlie Donnelly's body is. That is not for us in Phoebe to carry out any further work on the historic memorial group are working on. I think it's a wonderful film because it falls back on Bob Doyle's famous speech at Arama in 2007, when he asked the question, did his comrades die in vain? And that is a question that we have to answer. It's not for him to answer. He answered that question, and I think it's completely clear to us, or anybody who is politically minded, that fascism is alive and is at the moment triumphant. Whether it will succeed completely, again, that's our job, to make sure that it doesn't. And we do that through education, discussions, commemorations. And it's very important that today, 80 years on, and almost to the hour, there was a drew by about 2:25 on the 23rd of September. Today, Jack Nalty, 80 years on, is remembered. And it's important that we educate the people around. You know, that plaque raises questions among people who are not familiar with the subject and come on. Well, back in 2007 or 2010, we built the monument to Charlie Donnelly in Madrid. There was a concert afterwards. It was up near the Bernabeu Stadium. It was a big concert. There was quite a few Irish, about 150 altogether were there, along with Spanish people and other international brigaders as well. Families, and they decided that they would go to a pub afterwards for some refreshments. And I see one of the culprits here today. A couple of people, the debate was, how would we find a pub if we scattered in different directions? How would we find one another again in an area that we weren't familiar with? Two of our colleagues, Tom Greenlake, went off into the wilderness to find a pub that would be suitable for us, and back came the call, find the Guinness sign, and we went there. There was no sign of those two people. And we went and saw a pub with a sign on it, with the Guinness sign, and finished up in the most fascist pub in Madrid. It's not possible to do it, but we did it. We sang all night till 4 o'clock in the morning, and we were squealing beer from the pub that the two into an area where people were waiting on us, drinking Guinness and ran out of it. And there was a guy at the end of the bar, well-dressed guy in a suit, came in. He stood at the end of the bar all the night. And everyone that was going to the bathroom, he said to them, why do you remember? What is the point? Why do you remember? And any time that anybody wished to, you know, explain to them, he switched back to English. But it was very easy for us to answer the question, and I hope it is very easy for you to answer the question. You know, we cannot afford to forget. Thank you.
De la Quinte
Brigada or Viva la Quinta Brigada, that you all join in and that we commemorate those people who died and all the ones who are not mentioned who died as well. Because here today, we stand with them. 10 years before I saw the light of morning, a comradeship of heroes was laid. From every corner of the world came sailing the 15th International Brigade. They came to stand beside the Spanish people to try and stem the rising fascist tide. Franco's allies were the powerful and wealthy. Frank Ryan's men came from the other side. Even the olives were bleeding. As the battle for Madrid, it thundered on. Truth and love against the power of evil, and brotherhood against the fascist tide. Viva la Quinta Brigada! No pasarán, the pledge made them fight. Adelante is the cry around the hillside. Let us all remember them tonight. Bob Hilliard was a Church of Ireland pastor. From Killarney across the Pyrenees he came. From Derry came a brave young Christian brother. And side by side they fought and died in Spain. Tommy Wood's aged 17, died in Cordoba. With Nafiana he learned to hold his gun. From Dublin to the Villa del Rio, where he fought and died beneath the Spanish sun. Viva la Quince Brigada! No pasarán, the pleasure made them fight. Adelante is the cry round the hillside. Oh, let us all remember them tonight. Many Irishmen heard the call of Franco. Joined Hitler and Mussolini too. Propaganda from the pulpit and newspapers helped O.N.O. Duffy to enlist his crew. The call came from men who'd support the fascists. The men of cloth failed again. And the bishops blessed the blue shirts in Dunlira as they sailed beneath the swastika to Spain. But this song is a tribute to Frank Ryan. Kit Conway and Dinny Coady too. Peter Daly, Charlie Reagan and Hugh Bonner. Though many died, I can but name a few. Danny Doyle, Blazer Brown and Charlie Donnelly. Lim Tomlinson, Jim Straney from the Falls. Jack Nalty, Tommy Patton and Frank Conroy. Jim Foley, Tony Fox and Dick O'Neill. Viva la Quinta Brigada! No pasarán, the pledge made them fight. Adelante is the cry round the hillside. Oh, let us all remember them tonight. Viva la Quinta Brigada! Viva la Quinta Brigada! Viva la Quinta Brigada! Viva!